So these are the ingredients required for making bottle gourd halwa. So this is bottle gourd which comes around 300 grams, for which the other ingredients are required is ghee, condensed milk and milk. So with this we can make a very yummy tasty bottle gourd halwa. We have seen carrot halwa, loki halwa and even kaddu ka halwa, everything, but I like bottle gourd halwa the most, and that's the best and yummy compared to all other halwas. This is my personal opinion. So let's get started with this. Before that, we have to peel this off with a peeler, the skin, and we have to grate it using the grater. So let me get doing that and be right back. You can use this peeler to peel off the skin, or you can also use knife, whichever is comfortable for you. So you can use the peeler to peel the skin off. It's very simple. Now we have to wash this off and grate it. You can see I have peeled this and cut this in this way to my easy access of grating, and I will be grating it piecewise, and I will not be taking this seed part, but as much as you can, you have to grate it and take it. Okay, but do not take the seed part. I'm not taking it out first, but I'll be grating it along with the seed, and when it reaches to the seed level, I will be not taking it. Everyone will have different types of graters, and this is the type of grater I'm using. You can use anything, thin or thick, but do not make it too thick, because it will be difficult to melt in the and get mixed with the milk and condensed milk, everything. So it is to always good to maintain a thin grater, or what you can do is, if you do not have a grater, you can always cut this into cubes and use chopper and chop it well, so it will be again forming it into a small fine pieces. That will also be good. So let me start grating now. So let's grate everything and keep it together before we start with the process. If it is difficult to hold on to this like this, you can also always keep it down like this and do it. And now if you want to know how to do it on the chopper, I will also show you that. This is the chopper I was talking about. Okay, so this has got a blade like this. We have to cut these loki or bottle gourd into small cubes, not too tiny. I will show you how big it can be, and that has to be put in this, keeping in mind the blades are not affected by the pieces, as in it doesn't come in between. I'm sure almost everyone are very much aware of how to use this, so I'll just show you how it has to be kept in this, and then I'll chop it into fine pieces and show you. Okay, now you can see it is kept like this, arranged in a way that it is not affecting the blades, right? And this is positioned perfectly in the center where it has to be. Now let's close this and chop it. So it is grated. Now you can see it is completely in a small cubic form. This is fine if you do not have a grater to do, or even this is easy to work on. You just have to make small cubes, take off the seeds. See, I have taken off the seeds and put it around this blade and just chop it. Okay, so let's do it either this way, or you can also always use the grater to grate it. I'm just showing you both the way so that You don't have to stop making it just because you do not have either one of this. So this is how the chopped one looks like. Okay, you can see a small cube, whereas the grated one looks like this. That's only difference. And I also request you to keep any one more. Now, since we are having at our own house, so this is not an issue. Otherwise, always make sure you either follow chopping process or grating process. Both mixed will not actually look good. However, it is going to be mixed up. But you know, to have a greater look, follow one method, either chop or grate. Now let's take a pan, keep it in the stove. There is no water droplets left, so now let's add ghee to it. I'm adding ghee, 2 spoons, 2½ spoon. Okay. To this, let's add all these grated bottle gourd. You have to keep low medium flame and not stir occasionally, but do keep stirring continuously. Since this is a pan, non-stick pan, you can leave some time without stirring, but make sure you're not leaving it for long without stirring. You can also see the bottle gourd is reduced compared to what it was before. So this happens, it comes down to a small quantity now. I've been doing this for about 2 minutes. Now another 3 minutes to go. By then you will see this sound will be reduced, after which you can add milk to it. Now this has been 5 minutes. I'm still doing it. It has to get softened. You can see it is much more better than the initial stage. So you have to make a bit more softer than this. So let's wait for another 2 minutes. Meanwhile, what you can do is, by the time this gets much more softer, what we can do is roast this in ghee and keep it aside, so that after adding milk and condensed milk, we can directly add this into the halwa. This gives a very good taste. So I am taking a small pan in which I'll add a spoon of ghee and roast this. This, let's add a spoon of ghee. And add those raisins and cashew nut. Just roast them a little. Kova we get. I don't find it here. So that is the best thing that you can add while making a halwa. But since it is not available here, I am using condensed milk. If I am using kova, then I will not be using condensed milk as much as I have used in this, as that is 200 gram. But I will reduce the amount and add kova. Kova is sweetless, but that gives a perfect taste. These milks has to get dried within this, not completely dry, but it has to reduce the intensity of this water level and get back to a thick form, to which we keep it in a low medium flame and keep stirring it. Okay, these milks has to get dried within this, not completely dry, but it has to reduce the intensity of this water level and get back to a thick form, to which we keep it in a low medium flame and keep stirring it. Okay, powder like form, right? Now let's make this a bit more thicker form, bit more, as in now you can see a small bubble forming here, that has to be reduced. Okay, now when it gets reduced, we can add the roasted raisins and cashew nut, also saffron on top of it to decorate. Now to this, if you wish to add some color, you can add pineapple yellow color to this and mix them well. This is totally an option. You can avoid this step if you want, but just to give a proper color look and just for a look, decorative method. Okay, I have added a very less, a small pinch. You can see now it is almost done, and the sugar level for us is perfect. You can add according to your taste, your sweet level, everything. These milk that you see here forming, that has also to be dried off. So let's keep in low medium flame again. I repeat, it should be in low medium flame. Do not exceed the flame, do not make it even medium, it will burn the halwa. I have added very small amount of color, so this is how it looks, slightly yellowish. Now this is all done. We have to decorate this with the roasted raisins, so let's decorate it and have a look. I have turned off the flame now. You can keep this decorated and add little saffron. Saffron is again optional. This is up to you. If you want, you can add it. This just gives us nice fragrance, and again it is for decorating. Thank you. So the bottle gourd halwa is ready. You can try at your home. It is really yummy, tasty, and very simple to make. You have to serve it when it cools down. You can either refrigerate it and serve it in a small bowl, or you can always just let it cool and then serve it directly. Not necessary to be refrigerated. As per this climate and this coronavirus affecting everyone, better to avoid refrigerating it. So you can just wait until it is cooled down and then you can serve it directly. I will show how it can be served. Tasty and very simple to make. You have to serve it when it cools down. You can either refrigerate it and serve it in a small bowl, or you can always just let it cool and then serve it directly. Not necessary to be refrigerated. As per this climate and this coronavirus affecting everyone, better to avoid refrigerating it. So you can just wait until it is cooled down and then you can serve it directly. I will show how it can be served. I'm going to serve now.
please do try this and let me know in comments. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.